He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Okay, so for this problem, we've got a substrate here which has a ketone functional group and a carboxylic acid functional group. And we are going to do two reactions with two different reducing agents. We've got sodium borohydride and we've got lithium aluminum hydride. So if you don't remember what these do, go ahead and check out my lecture on oxidation reduction in the organic chemistry playlist. And these are going to generate two different products based on the reducing capacity of these two reducing agents. So go ahead and see if you can draw the correct product for these two transformations. Okay, so we've got our two different reducing agents here, sodium borohydride and a lithium aluminum hydride. We know that those are both sources of hydride, H-, which is going to act as a nucleophile and attack a carbonyl and reduce some carbonyl-containing compound. But the key difference here is that sodium borohydride is a soft reducing agent. It's a bit weaker, whereas lithium aluminum hydride is a hard reducing agent. It's a little bit stronger. So there's a discrepancy in what kind of carbonyl-containing compounds they are able to reduce. As it happens, sodium borohydride is only able to reduce ketones and aldehydes. Okay, this is because the ketone and aldehyde functional group, the partial positivity on this carbonyl carbon differs from that of, say, a carboxylic acid. Because this carbon, there, remember that this adjacent oxygen atom is able to put electrons onto that carbon via resonance. And so that is the reason that this is not as partially positive and therefore not as electrophilic as a ketone or aldehyde carbon. So that means that just the discrepancy in electrophilicity between this and this means that sodium borohydride is able to reduce this ketone functional group, but not the carboxylic acid functional group. So as a result, on the product, after reducing with sodium borohydride, we can see that the ketone has been reduced to the secondary alcohol, whereas the carboxylic acid has been untouched. It does not have the ability to reduce the carboxylic acid, so that won't change. However, lithium aluminum hydride is able to reduce ketones, aldehydes, carboxylic acids, esters. It is a stronger reducing agent. Because it's stronger, it is able to reduce not just this, but also this. And so, as a result, we can see in the product that the ketone has been reduced to the secondary alcohol, just as it has over here. But in addition, the carboxylic acid has been reduced to the primary alcohol. So the key here is noticing the difference in reducing strength of these two reducing agents and using that information to draw the two correct products. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.